I'm Elizabeth Muhm, engineer on the Google Maps platform visualization team. I'm here to tell you about data-driven styling for Google Boundaries, the latest addition to cloud-based map styling, now available in preview for the Maps JavaScript API. Data-driven styling allows you to customize the appearance of Google's polygons for administrative boundaries on your maps, including countries, states, counties, cities, postal codes, and more. This means for the very first time, you can programmatically customize the appearance of these boundaries based on your own logic and data to create beautiful, insightful maps. Let's take a look at how it works. To get set up, make sure you have a map ID with the vector map for JavaScript enabled. Next, create a new map style or choose an existing style, then choose the boundary types you want to enable for data-driven styling by selecting them from the Feature Layers dropdown. We'll go ahead and select Country and Administrative Area Level 1 for this example. These feature layers correspond to a subset of the place types you may already be familiar with from requests to the Google Maps platform Places, SDKs, and APIs. Now, all you have to do is associate your map style to your map ID, and you're ready to use data-driven styling. All right, let's get to styling. In this example, we'll start simple by outlining the borders of all countries on the map that currently support data-driven styling. I'm starting with a simple JavaScript app that loads the map using the map ID we just created, centered roughly on the middle of the United States. By default, when you load a map with data-driven styling enabled, none of the borders or boundaries are styled. So let's start simple by showing country boundaries. We begin by storing a reference to all available country boundaries by calling getFeatureLayer on the map instance and passing it one of the predefined constants available in the maps.js API for the feature type we want to style with data-driven styling. In this case, google.maps.featuretype.country. Next, we style the layer. There are two different ways to define a style for a feature layer. We can either pass in a feature style options object that defines the styles, or provide a styling function that returns a feature style options object, which is useful if we want to provide code that conditionally styles the polygons in the feature layer. The available style properties are fill color, fill opacity, stroke color, stroke opacity, and stroke weight. Colors can be specified in any format we would normally use for the web, including strings, hexadecimal, and RGB. Opacity can be set as a decimal or whole number from 0 to 1, where 1 is 100% opaque and 0 is completely transparent. And stroke weight is the number of pixels specified as a decimal or whole number value. The default is 2 pixels. To apply a style, we set the style property of our feature layer to an object that defines a stroke color of blue and a stroke weight of 1 pixel. Now we run it, and we have a 1 pixel blue stroke of all the available countries on the map. What you're seeing here are the countries supported by data-driven styling today, which will be expanding throughout the preview phase. So take a look at the documentation linked below to see the most up-to-date coverage by country. Next, let's expand our use of data-driven styling to create a choropleth map, which is a common type of map that uses fill colors to represent an underlying dataset. Here, a population dataset is being used to show the relative population of every state in the US, where different population ranges are represented with different colors. We'll start again with a simple map using the same map ID as before, but this time we'll get a reference to administrative area level 1 polygons. In the US, this is the feature type that corresponds to states. Next, instead of setting the style property to an object, we'll set it to be a function, which data-driven styling will run for every feature in the feature layer. When the styling function is called, data-driven styling passes in a place feature object that provides your code with its data attributes. These attributes include the display name, feature type, and place ID of the feature. So in this case, the names and place IDs will be for US states. Next, we look up the population for the state from a JSON object where the keys are state names and the values are the population. In this case, we're filtering the place feature objects by display name to keep things simple, but for better precision in production apps, we recommend that you use place IDs because they are unique. Then, add a simple conditional to assign a fill color to different population ranges, then return the style as a feature style options object from the styling function. And we have our choropleth map. These are just two simple examples of what you can do with data-driven styling for Google Boundaries. The API also supports click events and styling multiple feature layers on the same map. As part of this launch, we've also released a new region lookup service client library that makes it easy for you to prefetch the place ID of a feature polygon by providing a geocode or address. And as I mentioned before, we'll be adding more countries and more administrative boundary data coverage throughout the preview phase. So check out the link to the documentation below, where you'll find the most current list and more on how to use the region lookup service to optimize your usage of the data-driven styling API. The ability to access and customize Google's map boundaries is a long-time request from the Google Maps platform developer community. So we hope you'll give it a try in preview and let us know what you think. Thanks for watching and happy mapping.